The Neolithic era began when humans discovered the miracle of seed and topsoil. Certainly one of the most spectacular insights of the entire human adventure. Our Neolithic ancestors told stories of gods and goddesses to impress their discovery upon future generations. Though science does not think in terms of divinities, there is a way in which science proclaims even more deeply than the gods that soil and seeds have a cosmic significance. Whether through imaginative storytelling or secular science, we can come into relationship with the cosmic significance of seeds and soil. And when we do, our lives are enhanced by our resonance with the deepest cycles of nature.
I'm Brian Thomas Swim of the Human Energy Project. In our series of short films, we're exploring the way humanity is building a planetary nervous system. As we deepen our understanding of this planetary nervous system, which we call a noosphere, we discover a common purpose and meaning that will help us address our global challenges. For the rise of the noosphere, there are 8 conditions, one of which is cultural heredity. In this show, we look at the way in which Neolithic humans transmitted one of their deepest insights to future generations.
Through cultural heredity, the third story of the universe builds upon the Neolithic insights and even carries them further. We don't know the name of the human who first realized the connection between the tiny seeds that could fit in her hand and the giant redwood trees towering 300 feet in the sky. Her insight changed the course of human history. Seeds had operated outside of consciousness for 400 million years. But now, an incipient awareness of the power of seeds emerged in this particular human genius. She held in her hand something light as a feather, astonished to realize it could bring forth not only trees, but an abundance of food never before seen. Neolithic storytellers created symbols to convince their offspring to cherish seeds and soils. Typical was the story of the goddess Inanna, whose numinous power suffused all of life. Inanna's womb was the topsoil, her lover's semen, the seeds. Rain became the sexual act of pressing seeds into the magic of topsoil. In their annual rituals, the king processed to the temple as the woman who incarnated Inanna cried out,
"My womb, the boat of heaven, is full of eagerness. My untilled land lies fallow. As for me, who art Inanna, who will plow my womb? Who will plow my high field?"
These rituals enabled humans to remember that with seeds and soil, they were participating in something of supreme importance. They were forming relationships with the whole of life, which enabled them to navigate life's challenges more successfully. This process of creating stories to convey wisdom to future generations is called cultural heredity and is one of the key conditions that contribute to the noosphere rising. In this sense, the noosphere is a sphere of knowledge, an accumulation of human wisdom, one that exists as a collective consciousness. And with every generation, our collective consciousness grows stronger. The ongoing investigations of science have led to our realization that soil's magic comes from trillions of microorganisms. Our bodies depend upon the health of these organisms. When we regenerate soil's vitality, all advanced life, all plants and animals, including human consciousness, blossom forth. Even more can be said. We now know there are 400 billion planets in our galaxy. Of these, 6 billion are Earth-like planets that could be alive. What we are beginning to suspect is that the dynamics of the Milky Way galaxy are cosmic soil and Earth, and these Earth-like planets are the seeds. Some of these seeds have developed oceans. Some of them might have developed life, and one of them, without question, is well on its way to developing a planetary mind, a noosphere.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. Devin O'Day here, director of the Story of the Noosphere series. We had so much fun working on this episode. These ideas of sex and soil and life at the micro all the way up to the macro levels is so wonderful to reflect on. I love this idea of Earth within the soil of the Milky Way galaxy. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like or subscribe to our channel, and you can subscribe to our newsletter through the notes below. This series, it's an exploration. It's an ongoing conversation, and we invite you to that conversation. You can do so through commenting below or emailing us at hello@humanenergy.io. Thanks again for watching. See you next time.